What's up, BFam? You're still with me, your Barbie girl, Shania Gomez. Our admiration for our hobbies, collections, or even food can also be strengthened through exploration. Our constant need to learn about things we love allows us to appreciate it even more. When it comes to food, I believe the best way to find new pinasarap and pinasaya recipes is through season 2 of Tasteful Secrets. Today, Miss Dorita Rose is bringing us all the way to Irvine, Los Angeles. Get ready to discover Felsen Palad's Picadillo dish. Here's Tasteful Secrets with NutraAsia.
We all lead such fast-paced lives, pero may mga bagay na hindi dapat natin i-compromise, katulad ng preparing meals at home. Well, thankfully, with a little bit of help from quality ingredients and a lot of love, we can whip up the heartiest, most nutritious, most delightful dishes that inspire pinasarap, pinasaya moments with the entire family. Hi, I'm Dorita Rose, and this is Tasteful Secrets Season 2. Hi everybody! Most of you may know me as a former MTV VJ, a TV host, and an actress. And while nai-enjoy ko ang lahat ng mga yan, I think that first and foremost, my heart belongs in the kitchen. Kaya naman, for the second season of Tasteful Secrets, I am so excited to bond with you guys over feel-good stories and, of course, delicious and healthy recipes or meals, which I have to mention to you are easy to prepare because, of course, we all live and lead such fast-paced lives. So for today's episode, please indulge me as I introduce our special guest. He is an accomplished vocalist, singer, composer, and musical director who has conducted numerous concerts for church ministries around the world. He was born in Dasmariñas, Cavite, and actually used to teach food microbiology to college students, but now cooks over-the-top delicious meals for his discerning, gorgeous, beautiful, and sexy wife. Please welcome the most handsome man on the planet, crooner extraordinaire, Felsen Palad, my husband.
Hello! Am I gonna be singing?
Yes, you will later. Later. He's excited. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy to have you with me on the show. For today, he's going to be cooking a dish of his. And that is?
Picadillo.
Picadillo.
But for Hispanic people, they would say picadillo.
With a double L as a Y.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So what is the difference between picadillo and picadillo?
Well, first, the pronunciation. And it's both Hispanic dish. But for Filipinos, we have a twist, of course. We have a twist.
What's the twist?
Well, our secret ingredient is the banana ketchup.
Okay, why is it banana ketchup? Why not regular ketchup?
Well, it goes back to a beautiful history of the Philippines during Hispanic times, that tomato sauce was actually a little expensive, you know? But as resourceful and inventive as Filipinos are, you know, there was an abundance of plantain in the Philippines. So we made our own ketchup.
A little funny story. So we've been married for like a year and 2 months already. And so on the third day of marriage, you know, and he said, "Can I cook for you?" And I was like, sure. I'm super picky when it comes to food, okay? So I was just indulging him in my mind. I'm like, now he knows the truth. And I didn't know he could cook. So he was like prepping and I was like, ooh, he knows how to hold a knife. He's got pretty interesting ingredients there. Up until the very end, when he was about to put the banana ketchup, I was like, can you hold the banana ketchup? What are you doing? Because I'd never really tried picadillo before. And he's like, can you just step away? Like, this is, today's my day. So I was like, okay, he's gonna ruin the dish, right? But when he presented the dish to me and I tasted it, my jaw dropped. I was like, oh my gosh, I hit the jackpot. I married the right one.
She hit the jackpot. I hit the debts. Just kidding.
Can I have a pound of ground pork?
Yeah.
So, here here's the ingredients.
Okay, so we have ground pork, potatoes, carrots. We have parsley, which is what we're going to put on at the end, tomato paste, cranberries, which are rehydrated because since they were dried, knob of butter, garlic, onions,
fish sauce,
and bell peppers, and cheese and tomato sauce, salt and pepper.
Yes.
Okay, let's get started.
So we're going to oil it first. Mind you, hindi ako professional na chef like you, but this is like lutong bahay.
But guess what? This guy, he used to own a catering company that would cater to 3,000 employees in Cavite. Mm-hmm. So I think the kind of work that you've done is way more laborious than what I've done.
Yeah, I put the onion first kasi mas madaling mag-brown yung garlic.
Ayaw natin na masunog.
Yeah. Can you put the tomato sauce here?
Oh, okay.
See, it's very colorful.
White, we've got orange, green, red.
Mm-hmm, right?
And purple from the red onion.
That's why I said it's all season. Because all seasons have colors, right?
Fish?
Yes, fish pala. Yan.
It adds depth of flavor.
Yes.
That umami saltiness.
Yes. All right, and then this is the time that we use our secret ingredient. Ta-da-da!
Ah!
UFC tamis anghang banana
ketchup. You see?
It's red.
It's red. So it's similar to regular ketchup, but a little sweeter.
Filipino ketchup. So we're gonna put
1 cup.
So the combination of saltiness, sweetness, and everything.
And savory.
Everything.
Ready?
Yes.
1, 2, 3. Oh my gosh, look at all that.
The color, the smell. You know, I think everything is better with extra cheese.
So, you couldn't help yourself.
I know. There you go. Just like, you know, parang ang spaghetti, but it's not.
It's spaghetti with rice.
It's spaghetti with rice. It's very colorful, very nutritious because we have our veggies there, our little carbs, my vitamins, rich in vitamins, beta carotene, and protein. So we want to invite you to do the same and use UFC banana ketchup. Tamis ang hang.
So, there you have it, Felson's Picadillo.
Mm-hmm.
Yay! So
taste test.
Okay, and
taste
of course, test. We can't eat picadillo without rice. without rice, okay?
Without rice. So, rice is life.
So we put this on top. Ooh. Got some of those cranberries in there, all the ingredients. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I didn't make it very pretty. And then, of course, I like to add extra cheese. And let's try it.
Mmm.
Nako, proud ako. Very good. Good job in highlighting a product from the Philippines that brings this dish over the top.
Banana ketchup is more of like a tradition for Filipinos.
Mm-hmm. There are certain things that you can't eat without banana ketchup, and one of them is picadillo. Cheers. Mmm. You see? Delicious food does not have to be complicated. With quality ingredients, any dish can be pinasarap, pinasaya, especially when done with love and care. Thank you for bonding with us today, and we hope that you'll tune in again for more easy and delicious recipes. Dito lang sa Tasteful Secrets Season 2, Mas Pinasarap, Mas Pinasaya.
Thank you so much, Miss Donita Rose. Feeling ko I now have the perfect dish to make for my family this holiday season. But BFAM, let this be your reminder that the holiday season has always been about celebrating connections and developing even more appreciation for everything that fills our hearts. We all need a little more support during these times. I hope you find the courage to reach out and give love to those who need it most. If you want to see more stories of unique Filipino relationships, just go to ABS-CBN Entertainment YouTube channel and search for VRGY. You can also watch our episodes through the I Want TFC app anytime, anywhere. Just download the I Want TFC app by Google Play Store for Android users and Apple App Store for iPhone users, or visit iwanttfc.com and watch your favorite Kapamilya shows for free. I'll see you all next time. Once again, this has been your Barbie girl, Shania Gomez, here on The Place to Be. Be happy, be you. VRGY.